Welcome to the ThinkCell tutorials. This video provides step-by-step instructions on how to create pie and donut charts with ThinkCell. Pie charts and donut charts are actually special cases of a 100% chart, with only one category of data. Both chart types work very similarly in ThinkCell. To insert a pie chart, go to the ThinkCell group in the PowerPoint ribbon, open the Elements menu, and click on Pie. Click again to place the chart on the slide. The default data sheet uses percentage values. If this is the format you would like to work with, just type in your percentage values in column B and name the different series in column A. In our example, the sales regions. You can also use absolute values in the data sheet and have ThinkCell calculate the percentages in the chart. To do this, select column B and click Add Remove Percent Formatting of Cells in the toolbar of the datasheet. The format of the cells changes to absolute values. Now you can enter the absolute values for your different series into the datasheet. ThinkCell automatically calculates the percentage values in your pie chart, assuming that the sum of the absolute numbers you entered is the value for 100%. Now that you have added your data, let's turn to editing the look of your chart. By default, the slices of your pie chart are displayed clockwise according to the order in the datasheet. If you would like to change this, left-click on the chart area to open the floating toolbar. Click on the Segment Sorting control and pick your preferred option from the drop-down menu. You can choose between Sheet Order Clockwise and Sheet Order Counterclockwise. Or, to arrange the slices according to their size, ascending order clockwise and descending order clockwise. You can also freely rotate the pie chart. Suppose you would like to have the pie slice for Asia displayed at the top of the chart. Click on the slice to select it, then click and drag the outer middle handle to rotate the pie chart to the position of your choice and release. ThinkCell remembers which handle you were dragging when rotating the chart and preserves the correct orientation, even when you change the data later. You may also explode a slice of the pie chart to highlight it. Just click on the slice, drag the outer middle handle outwards, and release. Finally, let's say you would like to change the position of one of the outer series labels. Just hover over it, click on the drag handle, and drag it to the desired position. Let's turn to the donut chart. As mentioned, the donut chart works very similarly to the pie chart. In fact, you can easily turn your pie into a donut chart by selecting any slice with your mouse, and then clicking and dragging the handle at the very center of the pie outwards. The handle snaps to the default hole size for a donut chart. In our case, 50%. Release the mouse button. If you prefer a different hole size, click and drag the handle inward or outward. If you are happy with the hole size, release the mouse button. You have turned your pie into a donut chart. To insert a donut chart from scratch, go to the PowerPoint ribbon, open the Elements menu, select Donut, and click onto the slide once. Entering your data, rotating the chart, ordering, and exploding slices works just as it does with the pie chart. If needed, adjust the size of the donut hole by selecting any slice and dragging the inner handle. Of course, you can also turn your donut into a pie chart by dragging the handle to the very center. Additionally, you may add a title label to the very center of the donut chart. Right-click onto the donut hole and select Add Title from the context menu. By default, the label shows the absolute total of the chart, but you can also use it differently, for example, by typing text directly into it. As with all ThinkCell charts, you may also insert a legend to your donut or pie chart. Right-click onto the chart area outside of the slices and select Add Legend from the context menu. All series labels are moved from the edge of the chart to the legend. If you would like to move only individual series labels to the legend, right-click onto the corresponding slice label and pick Add to Legend. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please visit our website for more ThinkCell tutorials.